Catherine and Mike, thank you very much. The Caps have sold 97% of the tickets in their first 12 home games. The crowds are coming back to watch Alex Ovechkin. Tonight's starting goaltenders are brought to you by Nissan. Manny Fernandez has won 7 in a row, the longest win streak for a Bruins goalie since John Casey in February of 1994. His last time out, 20 saves and a shutout at Florida. Brent Johnson at the other end of the ice in his last 5 games, struggling a little bit, 2-3 with a 3.21 goals against average and an .885 save percentage. The Bruins come in here having equaled their season high with 5 consecutive wins. 14-1-1 in their last 16 games. The game is on, and Brick, the Washington Caps can be explosive, especially early.
Yeah, this is a team that can score goals, Jack. They got a lot of talent up front, good speed, and they love playing here at home.
Michael Nylander off the boards, brings it back to Sean Collins all the way through. Alexander Giroux on the near side, who was red hot when they brought him up from the American Hockey League. He had scored 18 goals and 12 assists, 30 points in 25 games. Kozlov looks for Nylander in the seam. Giroux brings it back to the point. This is uncommon vocal support for the Washington Caps. We get a whistle on a Caps touch of the puck.
Yeah, I think it's Morrison, the defenseman, the former Bruin at the left point, Jack, that's going to go to the penalty box. Giroux had the puck on the backhand, slid it back to the left defenseman, Morrison, and he was under a little pressure from Chuck Kobusu. He's going to get a stick up a little high, right in the face of the Bruins' right winger. That's your penalty. Not the way you like to start a hockey game if you're the Washington Capitals. Conversely, the Boston Bruins on the power play.
Huge chance for the Bruins here. Char running the show from out top. Mark Savard in his first shift has the power play, and he'll take it from the half wall. Tries to drive and a save by Johnson. Axelson is the low man, and Michael Ryder also out there. Patrice Bergeron at the opposite side from Char. Bergeron back to Char, the one-timer, save Johnson, rebound loose, and Johnson finds it between the knees.
That's a good shot by Zdeno Chara because he has Steckel right in front of him, and to get it past the shot blocker and get it on goal, that takes some concentration and some talent. And Steckel trying to front him. Johnson did get a good look at it though.
Dave Steckel, number 39 in red, wins the faceoff from Bergeron. He's a big Wisconsin boy. Steckel is 6'5" and just excels in Bruce Boudreau's system. Brooks Light works all the way to the corner. Savard puts a bump to him. Axelson back to help out. Light keeps digging away. Caps fans think he was tripped over a stick. Savard, saucer pass, wing to wing, and it deflects up and out. As Tom Pody returns to the ice after missing 6 games, groin problem, but he has returned as well.
Well, he's had 2 or 3 seasons, Jack, where he has scored double figures in goals. Just 2 last year, a little uncharacteristic of Tom Pody, but already with 3 this season, and those 3 goals all coming in the last 10 games.
This Bruins power play brought to you by Jeep. Dennis Weidman and Matt Hunwick on the backside with the Peach Fuzz power play up front. Krejci, Kessel, and Lucic, but it's offside.
The idea coming through the neutral zone with this group on the power play, you have 2 players coming up the right side, Krejci and Kessel, and as Krejci goes to the middle, Jack, it opens up the wide lane for Kessel. We saw it last game against Tampa. Very effective.
Brick, you're a power play guy. Is it difficult to have your first shift of the game on the power play? Do you like to get a lather going first?
Yeah, you actually do. You know, you've been in that locker room for about 15, 20 minutes. You've gone through the national anthem. You've waited for television to start the game. And your first shift on the power play, sometimes it's not that great.
Kessel's shot deflected. Carl Alsner knocks it all the way to the far side. Lucic from his knees can't make the play. And the Caps clear at the length of the ice. It's Milan Yurchina snapping at 200 feet. Half a minute to go on the Boston man advantage. Dennis Weidman bringing it across the line, but Yell ran into Brooks Like, who turned his body, keeping Yell inside the zone.
Well, they're calling a penalty on the play here, and I think it's going to be against the Bruins. I think it's going to be an interference call, and I think it's going to be on Yell
setting
for such
pick.
Play.
Yeah, setting a pick.
See if we get a look at it. Weidman carrying the puck. Here's the body contact between Yell and Like. The officials call the penalty.
So it goes to 4-on-4. Where, strangely enough, the Caps only have one goal for in this season, and their 4-on-4 goal differential is -1.
And they're going to go with three forwards right off the bat. And, you know, they also got an eye on the clock because there's only about 20 seconds left on the penalty to Morrison.
Cody and Ovechkin back. Johnson flips to the boards. It's Savard looking for Weidman off his skates. 3-on-1 coming up ice. Ovechkin racing up the weak side, but it's offside as the first shift for Semin. Now, here's a little tussle in the corner as Savard goes over and takes exception.
Yeah, Savard and Bodie having a little exchange. Unbelievable that the Caps would go offside in that situation. They had a 3-on-1. And how about the three guys that were coming? As we get a look at Savard and Pody, exchanging holiday best wishes. But a 3-on-1, and you had Semin, Backstrom, and Ovechkin coming at you, and it was offside at the Bruin blue line. Bruin defensive blue line.
Bergeron wins the faceoff against Backstrom. Minute and a half of a power play coming as Morrison skates out of the box. Tom Pody out of his own zone, leaves it off for Ovechkin, who's got that explosive acceleration. Pass Bergeron, stick check. Alexander Semin around through both corners. Backstrom gives it back to Pody. Semin top of the circle, his shot saved. Fernandez can't gather the rebound. Kozlov digging after it. Weidman turns, fires through the corner. It goes all the way to Johnson.
Well, Semin can really shoot the puck, Jack. And when he gets an opportunity to curl off the half wall, he is going to shoot that puck.
Semin with 13 goals and 14 assists in 16 games. 27 points in 16 games when he had the back and shoulder injury. He was so far ahead in the individual scoring race. Tom Pody, 40 seconds to go with a man advantage. Backstrom very crafty. Pody fakes the shot. Ovechkin could do anything from there. Semin on the half wall now. Kozlov very crafty, strong in the puck. Backstrom fans. Ovechkin shot scores.
They like their first periods. And I'm not sure if this puck was just a clean shot by Ovechkin that wasn't deflected to beat Manny Fernandez. And I'm also not sure if this play was designed to get the puck to Ovechkin. It seemed to change direction. Maybe Backstrom gets a piece of it. Semin to Kozlov. And Backstrom's in that slot area. When that play doesn't work, Ovechkin's perfectly positioned, almost in like a power I formation to get that pass. And he drips a pretty good slap shot, maybe deflected by Backstrom. It appeared to change direction.
Yeah, I think that hit Backstrom's stick on the way in. To hear the Caps fans screaming like this is good for hockey.
Well, you know how Detroit on their power play, they get almost in a linear formation. So if the first pass is either unsuccessful, Jack, or it's let go, they know that they have their teammate right in line to receive the puck. And I'm not sure if that's the way Washington will run their power play. We'll get a look at it perhaps in a future power play in this game, but it was a well-designed play. And it sure looked like Backstrom deflected that shot. Had to be his goal.
They are crediting Backstrom when allowing the first goal. The Bruins are 6-1-2 this year. That is the second best winning percentage in the NHL. A point percentage of 778. The league average when allowing the first goal is just 408. San Jose 9-1-1 when allowing the first goal. The best in the league. Lucic cruising on the left wing and his shot deflects up and over. Nicholas Backstrom just turned 21 in the final week of November.
Ninth goal of the year for Backstrom. And this guy was the runner-up for the Calder Trophy as the rookie of the year last year, losing out to Patrick Kane for the Chicago Blackhawks. Had 55 assists, 69 points last year as a first-year player. Pretty impressive.
Brooks Light past Oscar Osola, number 48, who was just called up from the Hershey Bears today. And Osla wheels into town with 16 goals and 6 assists, a plus 17 in 26 AHL games. Yet another one coming up from the farm.
Yeah, like the Bruins, Jack, what Washington has built here as far as their structure within the organization, it catches your attention because, you know, you take a look at Hershey, their minor league club in the American League. Last time I looked, they were like 20-5. Very similar to what they're able to accomplish in Providence. And then as players come up, they fit right into the system and they make contributions.
And here is Osla. Weidman breaks him up at the line. You know, it's interesting, Brick, that the two teams that went completely against the grain coming out of the lockout, blowing up their rosters, assuming they'd be able to sign free agents like pennies from heaven, were the Bruins and the Caps. And it was a disastrous backfire for both. But now 4 seasons out of the lockout, look how both franchises have recovered in a seeming endless stream of young talent. Lucic, part of that for Boston. The centering pass doesn't connect with Kessel. Both of these teams had very exciting seasons last year. Both have young nuclei around which they are building and coaches who have established tremendous systems. We could be seeing a lot of these two teams atop the Eastern Conference for a long time. Seven looking for the tip from Backstrom, and that's how high speed it is. That's about a 70-mile-an-hour pass looking for the tape. Bergeron for Axelsson. Pody slams him with the body to keep the puck in the zone. Again, it's Seven whipping it low for Ovechkin. Ovechkin assuming there was somebody at the right point, but there was nobody home, and Knighty finishes his check on Ovechkin.
Don't turn that puck over in your own zone between the tops of the circles of the blue line, because that counterattack, quick strike offense by Washington will hurt you.
Kovacsu in the middle of the Boston defensive zone. Axelsson, his pass broken up. Sean Morrison shoving it forward to the red line. Morrison to Backstrom. Sends it across the zone to Sean Collins. Not the UNH Sean Collins. It's the Ohio State Sean Collins. I think the UNH version is playing in Finland now.
We saw our UNH guy just before the game started, didn't we?
Rod Langway, one of the all-time heroes, and what a Hulk. Here comes Ryder on the right wing. The snapshot, an easy save for Johnson. And he covers up to get the faceoff. First goal of the game. On the power play, Nicholas Backstrom makes it 1-0 for the Caps. Enjoy a chowder. That dapper man behind the Caps bench was once a Baltimore skipjack at the same time Andy Brickley was.
What a terrific player he was in the American Hockey League for years. Had about 70 points in maybe 140 games in the NHL. Good offensive mind, and it's apparent the way he coaches.
Yeah.
Unless these offensive guys play to their strengths. 37, 17, and 7 last year when he took over in November. First place in the Southeast Division.
Fernandez pokes it free as Weidman had a nightmare with Kozlov draped all over him and using the big, strong reach. Well, the Caps can get you in a heap of trouble in a hurry.
Well, we mentioned it already, Jack, that you don't want to turn that puck over ever anywhere on the ice, but it happens. You just don't want to turn it over in your own zone, particularly out in that area, because now you're really in no man's land when it comes to getting back in a defensive position.
Tyler Sloan on the hit on the half wall, keeping the puck alive for Dave Steckel down in the corner. Sloan keeps it in at the left point. Past Ryder. Brashear gives it away to Weidman. Slips the short pass to Krejci. Hits Wheeler on the tape on the off wing. Throws it down into Pody's corner and picks it up himself. Pody doesn't get much of Wheeler on the hit. Wheeler strong out of the corner with the puck. Looking through the seam. Back to Charles. The one-timer saved by Johnson. He'll take the faceoff. Tonight's twisted but true fact of the game is about Bruce Boudreau, brought to you by Twisted Tea, hard iced tea. This game for Bruce Boudreau is his 89th behind the bench, and that makes him the longest tenured coach in the Southeast Division, because Carolina whacked Peter Laviolette. So there you got him. A guy who's been on the job for a little over a year, and he's the senior member of the coaching fraternity in the Southeast Division. On the forecheck, Yell taps the puck loose. Collins into the corner to Backstrom. Al Morrison wrists it into Chara's corner, goes in with a big hit. Ovechkin lifts Yelp's stick, produces the turnover, seven pirouettes past Yelp, drives it back into the corner. Looks like he recovered from the injury. Hunwick strong in a buck, one arm on the stick to hold off Backstrom. Now he's got to dig away in the corner, try to win it back. Chara to the left of Fernandez with seven closing. Chara gives it away to Backstrom at the Boston line. Chara gets a second chance and finds Yelp at the red line. Now he'll rip it in. John Morrison taps it forward a little bit too far forward. Savard takes the turnover. Lucic in the middle of the shot, save, rebound. Kessel trying to knock it out of the air, but the puck was about shin high and a tough chance for Kessel.
Yeah, tough luck. Phil Kessel perfectly positioned, and the shot by Savard had that in mind. If there was a rebound, have it go in that direction.
Kessel to Lucic and then looking for the tip from Savard, racing up the slot. It goes up off the glass and then deflects into the protective netting.
You know, when you do drills in practice, Jack, even if it's a 2-on-1 or a 2-on-0 even in practice, what you're working on when you come down the offside is to shoot the puck in an area where if you're not going to score from this angle, where do I want the rebound to have a chance to go? By shooting far side, that height, difficult for Johnson to control the rebound, and went right in the direction of Phil Kessel. That's what Savard had in mind.
Savard in the corner. Lucic gets a second chance. Like loses his stick. Mark Stewart over to Shane Knighty. Top of the slot, Lucic turns it back. Stewart has room. Doesn't get much on the shot. Osner one-hands it. Lucic tries to turn it back to the middle. Savard fighting for the puck. Comes to Knighty's side of the rink. Lucic bats it down past Light. Light out to center. Stewart wins it back. This was an important shift for the Bruins. First time they've really been able to set up in the tap zone, even strength.
Yeah, they had an earlier shift where Blake Wheeler took a breakout pass. First it started with Wyman, then to Krejci, then to Wheeler. Wheeler one-on-one with Pote. What did he do? He chipped it in behind him. That's the message I'm sure the coaching staff is giving the Bruins, that that's where we need to play. We need to do that more often.
Axelsson makes the smart play against Tyler Sloan, then goes cross ice. That opens things up for Bergeron to go into Pote's corner. Kobesu over to help out. Kozlov breaks it free to Nylander, returns it to Giroux, tries to get it to the forehand, nothing doing as Lashoff stands up well and deprives Giroux of the opportunity. They played against each other in the AHL. Weidman across to Lashoff. Matt Lashoff, the rookie, to Axelsson, tips it to Bergeron with Kobesu closing, rebound, saved by Johnson! The two saves of the night, first robbing Bergeron, and then Kobesu, and Johnson cannot get back to his skates. There was a collision with Kobesu flying through the middle. It was incidental, but the goalie looks a little dinged up. 9:20 to go in the first. We'll figure it all out when we come back. The Caps lead at 1-0.
Quality breakout by the Boston Bruins as they trail the Washington Capitals by a score of 1-0. Just about tie it up. Nice touch pass in the neutral zone by Axelsson. Two Bergeron, the two-on-ones created. And just like the rebound of the Savard shot, second chance opportunity. This time it's Kobesu, and what a save by Johnson. Fully extended left side of his body.
Came to the Caps on waivers in October of 2005 from Vancouver in his ninth season. In the 2002 playoffs, he was just on fire. 929 save percentage. Won a series. And then it sort of flattened out for him a little bit, but he's found a role here in Washington, and he's challenging for significant time with Jose Theodore.
Well, it seems like it's the year of the backup goaltender across the board in the National Hockey League. Guys getting opportunities that really aren't starters or number ones. And Theodore, the big signing in the offseason after Washington can't retain UA.
Steckel tries the centering pass. It doesn't get all the way through to Brashear. Axelsson chips off the glass. Kobesu chasing against Steckel. Brashear turns it back in the red line and wrists it wide right of Fernandez. In the trapezoid, Fernandez backhands it back through the corner. And Steckel jams it in again. Lashoff quickly reverses it. Kobesu takes it out of the zone but has to pay the price. A big hit from the 6'5 Steckel. If you're wondering, Brent Johnson did suffer a knee injury last year that cost him 5 games out of action. No way to know if that was what that situation was. Axelsson's passes have been right on the money tonight. That one just didn't connect with Ryder.
Make a holiday wish come true. Give the Globe Santa, where 100% of your donation helps buy gifts for thousands of local children in need. Visit GlobeSanta.org today. Give joy, give hope, and please give what you can at GlobeSanta.org.
Tyler Sloan off the end boards. Tom Pody, the Worcester native, chops it ahead. Ovechkin, the long saucer pass. Now, there's some soccer skill for you. Backstrom to Semin. It goes off the end boards. Ovechkin quickly on it. Chara throws the shoulder into the MVP, and that stops the puck. Ryder's outlet pass goes through Wheeler's legs. Pody off the penalty bench doors. Ovechkin, Chara throws him offline. Hunwick center circle, Krejci. He chips it in behind the D, but the Bruins go off for a shift change. Sloan hands it off to Backstrom. Nicholas Backstrom. Hunwick gets in a collision with Chara, and Backstrom picks up the loose puck unchallenged. Gurchina's drive tipped wide. I think Hunwick had the block to knock it out of the line of the goal.
Yeah, broke his stick on the play.
See my blog. Carl Alsner, number 27 in red. Think Don Sweeney, only bigger and stronger. He's a terrific young defenseman. Yell against Alger, who throws the shoulder into him. Thornton tries to center. Gurchina gets the shaft down.
Well, I'll give you bigger. I don't know about stronger.
Yeah, there you go. Penalty coming up against the Bruins is light. Handles the puck all the way to the goal line. Johnson gets to the Washington bench for the extra attacker, and here comes another power play. The Caps scored on their first man advantage of the night, and they're going to get another chance. And again, it's an interference call against the Bruins.
Well, this becomes a critical penalty kill now. I know it's early in the hockey game, relatively speaking, just under 7 minutes to go in period number one. But an interference call to Petri Nokalainen is going to put the Bruins maybe not in a must-kill situation, Jack, but when you're playing a team like Washington that's been so good at home, you do not want to get down 2-0, no matter what period it is. So the penalty killers need to do the job right here.
If I understood the public address system correctly, there was interference with a goalkeeper on Nokalainen. Pody forward for Semin. Backstrom crafty in the corner, drops back, passes it to the point. Ovechkin's drive goes wide on the glove side. Pody can't get it cross ice. Savard breaks forward. Ovechkin coming in late. No, it's Axelsson. Axelsson shot saved by Johnson. And a penalty coming against the Caps. It's a hooking call. P.J. Axelsson making it happen on the shorthand again.
Stick position, aggressive when you can be. And then he got some separation from Pody. Pody's got a long stride with a long stick, but Axelsson was able to get away from him. And I don't know if Ovechkin hooks Axelsson. I know he put a stick on him, but the referee's going to call it a hook. The back check by Ovechkin. Wow.
Wow.
You can see why Ovechkin did not like the call. The shot is gone when he gets his stick there. There's not much of a hook, but you see the referee with the arm up, and the Bruins catch a break. I don't know if they caught a break on the Nokalainen interference on the goaltender call, but they're certainly catching a break now with the penalty to Ovechkin.
Savard tries to shove the puck middle, but can't. It's good to hear an angry crowd in Washington. I guess there have been plenty of them over the last 8 years, huh?
I was going to say, not just at a hockey game.
Milan Urchina up to the line. Michael Nylander into the corner. Well, Brick, you really got a close-up look at Nylander in his time with the Bruins. What a crafty player he's been. Kessel busts past him, though. Now past Urchina. Goes to the short post and goes a-tumbling. The goal comes off its pegs. And Kessel gets up asking why there isn't a penalty.
I guess they thought that was a shove more than a cross check. Explosive speed by Kessel. In the neutral zone, he's able to get free of Nylander as well as Urchina coming down the off wing. Urchina, with that long reach, tries to bother him with the stick. He does just enough to force that puck to get away from Kessel in the follow-up shove. But we'll still play 4-on-4.
Morrison and Wheeler, a couple of 26s in the corner. Wheeler, the big reach, gets it around. Boyd Gordon gets a return from Hunwick. Morrison chasing Wheeler all the way out to the point. Collins through the corner. Weidman waits for it. 4-on-4 here. Weidman's drive. Oh, that hit Wheeler. And it dropped him. And the puck was actually stuck up Wheeler's hockey pants. And he is going to hippity hop and glide all the way to the Boston bench. That one really stung.
Yeah, what do you think of when you see that? Immediately you think Andrew Ferentz.
Backstrom all the way in, shovels it into the crease, and Weidman keeps his head about him while all heck is breaking loose. Ryder back to Weidman. Weidman gains the line, his drive saved by Johnson. He looks around for the rebound and it tumbles down in front of him. Well, this game is a little loose at both ends. 5:11 to go in the first period. The Caps have the only goal of the night.
1-0 you score. Capitals lead the Bruins. Dennis Weidman working that blue line, trying to get a shot through on goal. Blake Wheeler trying to get to the front of the net. He got there, Jack, but he was right in the shooting lane. That puck catches him up around the knee somewhere, lodged in the pants before it scored it free. Made his way to the bench, appears to be okay.
That just can't feel good, Brick. Phil Kessel, Savard, the Bruins about to go on the power play with Nokelainen standing in the gate. Dave Steckel rags some time off the clock. Washington wants possession, waits until it's shorthanded, and then ices the puck. Smart play from the Caps. Chara starts it out. He's got Hunwick on his left. Savard along the right wing boards. Chara goes in hard into the corner.
You got to have a little clock management. That penalty's winding down. And it's Ovechkin coming out of the box.
That's a scary thought. 65 goals a year ago. And Ovechkin's out. Puck turns right into the center circle. Kessel gets it loose, looking for Savard. Savard to Lucic, the shot deflects, changes speed, and Johnson makes the adjustment. Shots are 12-2 for the Bruins. Are getting plenty of rubber through to the Washington net. So if you're judging effort, I guess you have to say the Bruins are playing the kind of first period they wanted to play, but victims of the power play goal.
Yeah, they're starting to get the puck in deep where they want to. They put it in areas where they have a chance to get it back. I thought Washington stood up in the neutral zone a couple of times where the Bruins created two-on-one opportunities for themselves. The one two-on-one, Bergeron and Kobus, who nearly tied the hockey game, and then Axelson almost sent in another two-on-one with that same unit. And here we go again.
Bergeron chops it free to the neutral zone. Good, quick recovery, though, as Morrison gets back on the puck. Brashear shovels it over to Morrison on the open side, working on 90 side of the ice. Morrison cruises low, throws it off. Fernandez looking for the rebound all the way, and boy, Thornton rifles it off the end board. Bergeron wins the battle against Bradley. Kobus, who gets to the red line, taps it in. Boston will change up all five skaters.
I think it's something to watch for, though, Jack, because Washington wants to play that very aggressive up-ice style. Their defense want to hold their ground, whether it's on pinch-ins at the offensive blue line or in center ice. The Bruins could take advantage of that.
Ovechkin takes down Chara on the clock. Crowd goes nuts on that. Backstrom to Ovechkin behind the back, and Fernandez leads it all the way. Manny Fernandez is so cool. Seven, a little hop move. Comes off the end boards. Fans on the pass as Hunwick makes the stick check. Sloane in front, the tip try by Ovechkin, and Fernandez makes another stop. Manny Fernandez continues his outstanding play. Krejci draws it forward with Wheeler, who's back on the ice. Wheeler to Krejci to Ryder. Ryder's shot just wide on the stick side. Looked as if it might catch the post. Backstrom out to Ovechkin, and he wants to slow down the tempo and then rifles it off glass to go for the change.
I'm exhausted, I'm spent, I got nothing, but I can get a shot on goal from center ice.
Victor Kozlov, all 6'5 and 230 something. The wrist shot, glove save, Fernandez. Ovechkin and Chara, a couple of high priced, high spirited boys.
And high skilled, and they like the physical aspects of the game. Ovechkin's going to initiate the contact. Chara kind of got his feet locked up. Now he's got no balance. Ovechkin realizes, throws him to the ice. Got a tricky little backhand. He had two backhand opportunities from in tight, getting creative around the Bruin net.
Nylander hoping to win the draw to the shooter, Kozlov, but Yell has other ideas and brings it back. Weidman for Yell. Kozlov again picks it off. Kozlov has been a pass, really leading the Bruins pass as well so far tonight. Kozlov taps it past Nylander into Lashoff's corner. Lashoff around the corner. Nokelainen out. Can he bust past Collins? Collins with a check. cross ice pass for Thornton. His drive saved by Johnson, 4 feet outside the paint. He dribbles right back in the middle, and Thornton takes another whack at it. Yell keeps the puck alive. Thornton off the side of the goal and tips in front. Giroux lobs it to center. Lash off the diagonal for Thornton, waiting at the line as Washington gets some fresh legs on the ice. Thornton taps it in, and Boston completes a change. Osla, the rookie, tips it to Light. He rolls it past Mark Stewart. Matt Bradley on the go against Stewart, and Stewart wins the race for icing, and the drop comes all the way back to the Washington end with a buck and a half to go in the first.
Well, the Bruins have certainly worked this period. They've worked to get their opportunities. They have 14 shots on goal. They've limited Washington to six. But I will say, Jack, just a couple too many turnovers in their own zone by Boston has created some problems in their own end. They gave up the power play goal on the tip by Backstrom on the drive by Ovechkin, but they're in pretty good shape. I know Mike Bilbrey said even or better after the first 20. So with just about a minute and a half to go, they're looking to tie this game up.
In behind Yurchina. Savard steals it. Kessel tries to whip it middle. Yurchina again has trouble. Lucic. And then it's Savard getting banged down in a collision with Yurchina. The ex-Bruin kicks it over to another ex-Bruin, Sean Morrison. Lucic cleans him out, taking both of his edges off the ice. Final minute of the first period. Chara having some difficulty tonight. Light deflects the puck to the sideboard. Savard swivels it forward to Kessel. With Lucic filling in the middle, Kessel's shot off of the stick of Alzner. Light slowly out of his own zone. Oscar Osola on the off wing tries the shot. It goes off Stewart's legs. Pody, the defenseman, going in deep in the final 30 seconds of the period. Matt Bradley with a jump in his step gets into Stewart's corner. Stewart tries to reduce his space. Kovacsuk tumbles backward after the collision with Backstrom. Backstrom off the half wall brings it across to Tyler Sloan. Wrist shot pass actually looking for Bradley on the tip. 15 seconds to go. Ovechkin on the ice as usual in the final minute. Throws it into the middle. Looking for the tip by Backstrom. They connected on the power play goal. Ovechkin trying to accelerate past Kovacsuk. Stick check by Kovacsuk. Backstrom holds on edge looking for Ovechkin. Low circle. Tries to dangle around Kovacsuk, who isn't buying it. And the horn honks to end the first period. 1-0 for the Caps. Shots were 14-6 for Boston in the opening period.
Not a bad opening 20 for Boston. Don't like to see them down 1-0. The penalty killing gets victimized on a good goal by Ovechkin, or I should say a redirect by Backstrom. But again, I'll reiterate, too many turnovers in their own zone. They need to clean that area up and do more of what they did in the offensive end on a consistent basis come period number two.
Rick, during the New England Ford Dealers intermission report, we heard Mike Milbury say the Bruins have to challenge the Caps defense, putting the puck in behind them. A little speed, a little bang at the end of the play. Good recipe.
Absolutely. That's right on. And that's something we talked about in the first period. And when the Bruins did do that, they were highly effective. They also have to cut down on the turnovers in their own zone. And you heard Mark Savard mention that as well, especially with the Ovechkin line.
Lashoff can't handle the waist-high puck. Kozlov turns down into the corner and sets up, tries to cycle it low just to start things out. He's got Nylander with him. Kozlov goes through the legs. Lashoff plays the body, and Weidman takes the puck. Weidman tries to thread it through to Axelsson. It hits Kovacsuk. Second chance, and Axelsson tips it forward. Dave Steckel back after. Correction, Sean Morrison. As Nylander taps it back to Kozlov, pulls it to the dot, the shot saved by Fernandez. He controls the rebound. Bergeron chips it through the corner, and it deflects up and out, so there's no delay of game penalty. Or the linesman says it should be outside because it was off a cap.
Yeah, pretty good opportunity for the Washington Capitals. Nylander with that little peek to see where his support was. He knew he could go indirect off the boards behind him because Kozlov was filling. Kozlov, a pretty good chance inside the dot.
Matt Hunwick goes towards Semin. Lucic spins it to the center circle. It's Kessel. Savard closing. Savard shot. Save Johnson. Juicy rebound. Savard dives and one hands it back to Hunwick. Over to Char for the one timer. Glove save Johnson. And he glides over into Lucic.
Good play by Milan Lucic in the neutral zone to keep this play alive. Fed the puck through the center ice area where Kessel was coming with speed. He found Savard. And Savard's shot doesn't have a whole lot on it, Jack, because it's a little bit out in front of him. Well, you don't have the leverage to really hammer the puck. but he stays with the play, keeps it alive. Hunwick and Chara set up for the one-timer, but Johnson able to get out aggressive and make a glove save.
Kessel takes a face-off, wins it for a moment, but full credit to Oscar Osola going into the circle. Savard digs it loose, it comes along the wall. Bradley out into the neutral zone. Osola charging it against Hunwick. Osola holds him off in one arm, and then Hunwick throws him into the end boards. Carl Alsner, the defenseman, all the way forward. Osola, prolific scorer in the AHL this year, starts the cycle. Bradley leaves it off in the corner for Brooks Light. Lucic ties him up. He's got the loose arm off the stick around the shoulder. Centering attempt, and Hunwick sticks it back out of there. Correction, it was Lashoff knocking it out of there. No, third try, it's 90. Brooks Light closes in shot, save Fernandez, rebound, save Fernandez, and Lucic turns it out of the corner. Savard can't poke it past Urchina. Puck bouncing, it comes right to Light. Swivels it in front for Bradley. Kessel with the lift of the stick. And then from the far side, Osola misses, trying to get it on goal. Savard across the red line, dumps in, the Bruins will get a change. Ryder aggressively off the bench, chasing hard against Alsner. Alsner hits Ovechkin on the backhand side, turns to the middle of the shot, wide on the stick side, tries it from the low angle, and Fernandez quick post to post. Ovechkin will fire it from anywhere. He's averaging almost 8 shots a game in his last 8 games.
So he has the advantage because you want to pick him up as early as you can. You don't want to have him time and space with speed through center ice. Because it was a line change situation, he found some open space, and you get a pretty good idea of his skills. In flight, cutting to the middle, avoiding that long reach of Chara, backs the Bruin defenseman off to about the tops of the circles, gets inside for a quick little half slap shot.
In this age of shot blocking, it is amazing how many shots on goal Alex Ovechkin gets in the course of a night. Twice this year, he's had 11 in a game. By the way, this is the 38th anniversary of Johnny the Chief Busek's 1,000th game in the NHL when he had 2 goals and 4 assists, and the Bruins had 72 shots on goal that night in Buffalo. Nicholas Backstrom can't get through Mark Stewart, takes it all the way to the end boards where Stewart mugs him. Ryder takes the body to move the puck. On the far side, kept alive. Semin takes the shot, and Ryder gets his body in the way to deflect it out.
The Bruins and Toys for Tots will collect new toys at every Bruins home game in December. Donate a toy at the turnstiles and receive a voucher for a free kids ticket to an upcoming home game. For more information, visit bostonbruins.com.
Steklin yell on the faceoff to the right of Fernandez. The Bruins haven't been able to get it in behind the Washington D yet in the first 3 minutes of this second period. A lot of hop in the cap step. Boyd Gordon taking it behind Fernandez, wheels to the forehand, can't get the shot through Lashoff. Now Weidman feathers it out, gets it up and over Collins. Nokkalainen charging corner, he bangs with Morrison, the puck rolls loose. Brashear tries to turn away from Yell. Yell gets it loose to Nokkalainen. Nokkalainen back to Lashoff, the wrist shot goes off Gordon and deflects over to Steckel. Steckel takes the return pass and dumps in behind Fernandez. Fernandez waits for Steckel, over to Lashoff. He moves it up the wall. Thornton, the tip pass for Yell. Yell gains the red line, chucks it down into the corner. Nokkalainen on the diagonal. And he takes the hit to make the play, but the puck bounces loose into the circle, and Gordon spoons it out. Caps doing pretty well at keeping the Bruins' rush wide and predictable for Brent Johnson so far. His tip-in is from behind the red line, so it'll be icing against the Bruins.
Tonight, following Bruins Overtime Live, it's Sports Desk with Cole Wright, presented by FW Webb, home of Frank Webb's Bass Centers. Along with extended Bruins coverage, get the jacked-up call of the night from my mild-mannered partner. And get the latest on CC Sabathia heading to the Yankees. That's tonight, following Bruins coverage.
Your sarcasm is amusing, my friend. Tom Foti across the blue line, gets it back to one-timer, well wide. Nylander tapping the puck back down into the corner. Bergeron can't get it loose. Giroux steps across the goal line, it deflects off 90, and Fernandez pounces on the puck.
Yeah, mild-mannered, that puts you in the category of Superman, doesn't it? Was it Clark Kent mild-mannered?
Yeah, right.
Well, Jack, going back to your point about the Bruins getting the puck in deep, I think it's 3 occasions here that I've counted in this period where the Bruins have put the puck down deep to try to create some offensive flow. Axelsson did it, but they allowed the Capitals to come out. That led to the Kozlov chance, actually, that we showed a replay of from about the faceoff dot. And then the Thornton Yell Novalainen combination, they did it a couple of times, but the Bruins haven't been able to sustain enough, which tells me they need to win more one-on-one battles in the offensive end.
Bergeron to Axelsson. Off the end board, Sloan throws the body in on Bergeron. Kozlov strong through Axelsson. Stick check. Bergeron steals. Johnson alertly out. Whacks it out to his own blue line. It bounces past Giroux. One hands it forward. Nylander, pirouette, top of the circle. Cross ice for Pody. Pody closes the shot. Kozlov, save Fernandez. They score on the rebound. Alexander Giroux. It's 2-0 Caps.
The ability of Michael Nylander to control the puck and turn on a dime, this is what makes him so effective. He's able to pirouette quickly, spin off a check, and now that creates a seam. And Tom Pody jumping into the play, great timing, the former All-American out of BU, and a nifty little backhand feed for the shot on goal. And Giroux uncovered at the top of the crease, that second chance opportunity, something we see the Bruins when they're on top of their game allow very few of those opportunities. His first goal of the year, Giroux gives the Caps a 2-0 lead.
Well, the Caps make the most of the tools they have. Their forwards can bring so much pressure. And it takes some of the heat off their deep. Light works it to the half wall. Good solid body work by Chara, and Lucic lugs it over the line. Savard trying to whip it through the sticks to Kessel. Alsner ties up Lucic. Savard spins behind the goal line. Lucic out to Hunwick, tees it up the quick drop tip twice. Savard couldn't find it in traffic. Alsner, the safe pass up to Osla. 90 muscles it back. Lucic through the legs. Kessel gathers it up, tries to drag it back against the grain, but Matt Bradley clears. Kozlov and Pody on the assist. Here's Wheeler Watson. Oh, Johnson robs him. He threw the stick out and caught it at the knob. Made the paddle save. Bradley shot saved by Fernandez. Turns it forward. The rebound control to Ryder. It's Krejci over the line looking for a seam. Tries the shot. Saved by Johnson. And he sprawls out. Makes the save. And the fans rise to their feet in Washington. The Caps are feeling it. Up 2-0 against the top team of the East, the Boston Bruins.
Caps lead the Bruins 2-0. Bruins have had their opportunities. Kobesu robbed in the first period. And Blake Wheeler gets absolutely robbed here in period number two. Johnson wanted to use that stick as a poke check. Wheeler recognized it, took it to the forehand, just didn't have the leverage to kind of chip that puck or snap it up top because the puck was out far in front of him. Had to try to slide it into the net. And Johnson was able to quickly get that big paddle of his stick along the ice to rob Blake Wheeler. Wheeler trying to cut this lead in half and answer the Giroux goal tonight.
Krejci looking for Ryder in the slot. A good back check by Backstrom. Backstrom gloves the puck forward. And it's ruled offside as the puck was wiggling across the line.
On January 4th, join the entire Bruins team for a day of fun at the TD Bank North Garden at the 19th annual Boston Bruins Wives Charity Carnival, presented by the Floating Hospital for Children at Tufts Medical Center. For more information, visit bostonbruins.com.
Twice this season, the Bruins have been down 2 goals and have come back to win the game, once against Montreal and once against Atlanta. Chara all the way forward for Yell. Johnson turns and ices the puck, so the Bruins will get a free faceoff in the Washington zone. Shots in the game are now 17-14, so it's 8-3 for the Caps in the second period.
Well, trailing 2-0, you think of those two opportunities. Kobesu on the rebound of the Bergeron shot in the first period, and then, of course, Blake Wheeler. That little break in from about 45 feet in, and Johnson with two huge stops.
Ryder with the check to open that opportunity, but Pody takes it away from Krejci. The Bruins will dump it in again. Tyler Sloan plays it off the corner. Hunwick taps it back to the line. Wheeler waits to get it onside and again throws it in behind the D. The center Nicholas Backstrom goes back after, gets his skates tied up with Ryder on the forecheck. Alexander Semin in his return game gives it away at the blue line. Ryder tips it to Wheeler. Wheeler in traffic back to Ryder. The shot over the top glove side. Krejci backhands it back to the captain. Char puck on edge, throws it into the slot, knocked down there. It scorched to the sideboards and Krejci picks it up. Spoons it down to the corner. Backstrom and Ryder tangle. Backstrom stick handles behind Krejci, lifts it out through center. Hunwick gloves it down. It's ruled a hand pass, but probably a smart play by Hunwick with Semin trying to sneak in the back door.
Now the third best opportunity for the Bruins, a turnover by the Caps. The Bruins keep the play alive. Wheeler just held and held and held, and three Capitals drifted past the puck and allowed Ryder to get into that top slot or high slot area. He's had a hot hand lately, trying to go up over the glove of Johnson. Just missed up over the crossbar.
And Johnson took advantage of the situation, reading it pretty well. He came out aggressively and cut down the angle.
Big guy, too, about 6'3", 215 pounds. He takes up a lot of that net.
Petteri Nokkalainen down on the corner. Yell going over to help out against Morrison. Yell steps inside. Steckel to make the play. Thornton and Yell in the corner. Steckel going over, trying to pull the puck loose. Yell holds his ground. Pulls it away from Steckel. Slips it to Nokkalainen. The shot, he got it off the heel of the blade. Gordon at the red line. The lob, and Fernandez punches it out to the side. Brashear in the corner against Hunwick. Hunwick quick to the puck, pokes it up toward Thornton. Thornton battles it across the line to Yell, but the puck dies, and Steckel gets possession back. He turns and throws it in behind Fernandez for the line change. A little bit of difficulty as Brashear picks off the combination between Fernandez and Weidman. Bergeron goes back aggressively to win the puck and then scoop through to center. Carl Alsner from behind the red line, and the Bruins will try to capitalize on this mental mistake as they'll get a draw in the attacking zone.
Real long shift too for Donald Brashear. You saw Nylander out there along with Kozlov, but Brashear, because he went in to put pressure on Fernandez, didn't have a chance to get to the Washington Capitol bench, and now with the icing, he's going to stay out there.
Nylander wins another important draw. Yeah, I saw Nylander and Brashear out there at the same time. I'm thinking, one of these things is not like the other. Not usually line mate. Urchina wrists it through both corners. Stewart one-hands it forward for Kobesu. Kobesu caught in traffic. Kozlov out at the line, but Axelson's Johnny on the spot. Three on three coming back up ice for the Bruins. Axelson drops. Nighty hopping up on the play. Backhands it toward the middle. Bergeron working at corner against Kozlov. Urchina helps get it loose. Sloan pokes the puck up the wall. Little tap from Kobesu keeps it alive. Axelson spins it into the slot. And good work by Giroux, who has a goal tonight. Nylander winds it out long, sneak away up the middle, but it's offside as Giroux is a little too eager. Nylander saw the post pattern, but since the pass came from the defensive zone, the drop will come all the way back.
Looked like he had his foot in the air, and that's, I think that's why it was offside, Jack. The linesman right on the blue line. Foot in the air, but both skates crossed that blue line before the puck was, therefore the offside.
Michael Nylander in his 15th NHL season.
And Nylander didn't get all of that pass, too, which throws off your timing a little bit if you're the receiver of that pass.
Nylander had a bad shoulder injury last season, missed 42 games. Lucic slips it to Savard to Kessel, flying up against Pody, tries to curl and drag, and Pody's enormous reach breaks it up. Savard tries to keep the puck in the attacking zone and again has an angry exchange with Tom Pody. And Savard is clearly going to stand his ground. 9:54 to go in the middle period. The Caps have one in the first and one in the second. It's 2-0. Catherine, thank you. Joey Crabb has joined the Thrashers since the last time the Bruins saw him, and we're going to see Atlanta twice, Friday and Saturday. And we hope you'll join us for both of those, home and home, on consecutive nights. Starting at Phillips Arena in Atlanta. on Friday evening. Bruins trailing the Washington Caps 2-0. Washington is dominant on its ice as the Bruins have been at TD Bank North Garden this season. Milan Urchina wrists it into the pile. It comes off of Weidman's left leg and he flexes it with a little bit of anguish on his face. Brooks Light to Urchina. Weidman stabs the puck behind the goal out to Savard, swivels it behind Kessel. Lucic picks it up and carries it into the zone. Savard coming late. Lucic's drive well wide on the stick side. Savard quickly on the puck. Gives it back to Weidman. The one-timer tipped wide. Alsner chips to the corner. Lucic cycles it for Savard. Kessel trying to find some space in front. Savard loops it. The lash off the drive. Deflected and it goes off the side of the goal. Alsner, rather light, takes the hit to move the puck to Bradley on the near side. Bradley backhands it back to Light. He tips it over to Alsner, drags it out on the left side. Lucic with a big hit on Alsner, and the puck slides back.
Strong shift, body contact, using all five players on the ice. Savard, nice little pass from behind the net. Lucic had the redirect. Now you need that follow-up shift.
Wheeler tips it through to Krejci, racing through open ice. A sprawling play. Wheeler's shot. Collins made the defensive play. Ryder feeds it into the circle to Wheeler off the side of the goal. Wheeler tries to feed it in front. It bounces right back to him. Collins backhands it to the corner. Wheeler gives up the body to move it. Ryder trying to pull the puck back on the tip attempt. Krejci to Hunwick. Over to Char, the drive, and a save by Johnson, dragging the right leg pad. Ovechkin works on Char. Two of the greats going at each other. Char wins this battle. Flicking the puck to the corner. Backing quickly on Char. Center's looking for Ovechkin, who came in on the second wave. Blake Wheeler, stick handles over the red line. Chips it in. The Bruins will cut it off.
Well, despite the near chance for Ovechkin, good shift by that Krejci line.
Alexander Semin swivels on the half wall. Thornton tries to tie him up. Nokalainen stabs at the puck. Thornton digs it out to the neutral zone. Holds off the Nylander stick check. Yell goes underneath Sloan to keep it alive. Thornton digs the puck out. Turns in the circle. Pony uses the stick to push Thornton into the corner. Nokalainen on the loose puck. Yell has to chase it in Sloan's corner. Takes a funny bounce off of the kick plate and seemed to come right in front of Johnson. The goalie alert to it. Chara backhands it. Thornton shortens the stick to punt it along to Yell. Back to Thornton, throws it right on Johnson, and he makes the save. A pretty good follow-up from this Yell line as the Bruins bring some more pressure.
Bruins starting to roll their lines and get some good pressure in the offensive zone. Here's that feed from behind the net by Savard with Lashoff sneaking in. The redirect by Lucic. Body contact, and then we talked about the need for a follow-up shift, and here comes Krejci looking for a potential two-on-one. Nice defensive play, though. Collins leaving his feet. Good timing and positioning with the dive play with his stick.
Sean Collins, part of the Hershey Bears pipeline that comes up and contributes immediately. Knighty's pass right onto the stick of Steckel. His bomb saved Fernandez. And Knighty back to collect the rebound in the corner. Kovacu to Stewart, back of his own goal. Axelson up at the blue line, lifts Collins' stick, and the puck slides all the way down behind Brent Johnson. Brashear after it. Morrison off the board. Steckel gets a piece of the puck. Axelson back at the red line, goes indirect for Knighty. It goes off the linesman and dives right at the blue line. Kovacu takes it, tries the shot, saved by Johnson. A big rebound high off the apron. Steckel in the corner. Axelson ties him up. Sort of like the David Letterman Velcro wall, those Steckel's so big, but Axelson does a pretty good job of stopping it there. Savard digging away, recoils as something came up and hit Savard in the face. Collins glides over the red line, taps it forward. Brashear going into Stewart's corner. Stewart off the end boards. Brashear finishes his check. The long pass intended for Savard, a hand in the air, and it's going to be an icing call as Alsner gets the first touch.
Well, tomorrow night, catch an all-new episode of The Instigators to hear Mike, Jack, and I face off on this week's hottest hockey topics. Then visit Nesson.com for exclusive extra content not seen on the show. The gloves come off tomorrow at 6 and again at 10:30.
looks like, and Mark Savard on the faceoff to the right of Manny Fernandez. Stalemate, and Stewart will lug it forward. Lucic gains the line. Stewart gets a piece of the puck. Kessel hacks it into the corner. Lucic with a hit on Bradley to Savard. The shot saved by Johnson. Got a good look at it, and he hangs on. 5.5 to go in the second. Backstrom's tip-in goal on the power play in the first, and Giroux's goal early in the second. And it's 2-0 Washington.
Well, we're late second period, and the Boston Bruins have not been able to penetrate Brent Johnson. The big-time save on the rebound chance by Kobisu. You know, when I was ranking the saves by Johnson, I forgot about the absence and breakaway because there was a penalty to Ovechkin on that opportunity. And then a walk-in by Wheeler. Johnson again robbing the Bruins using that big stick for the goaltender. He's been impressive tonight. You know, it was about 5 or 6 years ago in St. Louis. He had a 34-win season with a low goals against. This guy can play.
Yeah, stole that playoff series as well. And he's had quality. I remember Grant Fuhr working with him for a while saying nobody should give up on this guy because he's got the talent and he's got a good work ethic. Dennis Wiedemann ropes it hard off the boards and it bounces onto a Washington stick. Carl Alsner turning away from Lucic. Kessel gets a piece of the puck. Taps it back to Wiedemann for possession. D to D to Lashoff. Lashoff from the red line. Bounces it in on Johnson. And he has to pin it to his body. Those bouncing pucks are always an adventure.
That's a good save because that puck changed directions dramatically when it landed on its edge. A D to D play in the neutral zone. Wiedemann across to Lashoff, who just gains the red line. Watch this puck. I mean, it changes direction by about, I don't know, 2.5 feet by the looks of it. And Johnson has to get it and get it with his left shoulder.
Tom Pody with speed away from Wheeler. Ovechkin chips it cross ice. Simmons return pass. Ryder breaks it back. He's got Wheeler on the left, and Wheeler jumps the line by a half a step.
Wheeler tried to drag that right skate to stay on side. Just couldn't do it. Ryder's going to try to move a little bit laterally as he's moving forward in order to create some separation and some space in hopes to create the two on one with Wheeler. And like Washington on their 3-on-1 back in the first period when they went offside, the Bruins don't get the opportunity they were looking for because of the offside call.
Krejci throws it low into Tyler Sloan's corner. Ryder going to work. Hunwick's drive knocked down in front. Ryder the rebound. Here comes Wheeler. The shot. Two saves by Johnson. Wheeler centering pass, but it's on Ovechkin's stick. Ovechkin chips it forward. Seven tries to bunt it back to him, and Wheeler turns it up ice for Ryder. Ryder has Krejci. Krejci's shot deflects and goes off the end board. Backstrom can't get it going. Ryder sends it to the opposite corner. Krejci reverses. Ryder looking over his shoulder. Sloan loses his stick trying to poke Ryder. It bounces low. Krejci steps over the busted lumber. Seven cross ice. Ovechkin goes wide to try to stretch Chara. Ovechkin tries to go behind the legs. Gets around. Chara has to go back to the goal. Centering pass. Shot goes wide on the glove side. Alexander Seven, about 6 feet away, had a good chance but couldn't angle his stick enough to get it on goal.
He showed that patience and poise of a goal scorer. Chara could not attack him, and he just missed on the glove side as Fernandez held his ground.
Thornton into the corner, and Nokalainen goes to work. The yell line again doing what you and Frank Milbury both observed, that the Bruins can have an advantage by going behind the D, making them try to work it out of the zone. And here it is, yell stealing from Collins, trying to slip it through. Nokalainen battles far side against Alexander Giroux. Two chances to clear, but Morrison can't do it.
He's using a right-handed stick, that's why.
Nokalainen loses an edge, gets it in front. Giroux chips it off the board. Thornton finishes his check on Giroux. 90 with Kozlov lurking, goes off the end board. Stewart reverses it. Giroux chasing 90 now. Stewart behind Yell. Urchina wraps it in. Fernandez can't control. 90 in the corner against Giroux. Nylander on a tour of the attacking zone. Cycles it from a distance to Kozlov. Kozlov shoves it back low. Nylander coming off the end wall. Giroux lurking on the weak side as Alsner takes it left point. Pass Coswell, there goes Giroux. Can't scoop it in front as Kovacsuk blocks the centering attempt. 2:20 to go in the second period. Bruins looking for their first goal of the night. Stefan Yell across the red line, wraps it off Urchina's stick, and it ends up being an offside. And the faceoff will come back to the neutral zone with 2:11 to go in the second. Difficult not to get discouraged in a situation like this, down a couple of goals, and you're starting to feel the clock go tick, tick, tick.
No, I don't think so. I think there's way too much time left. I think it's the only frustrating part is you've had really good opportunities that you haven't buried.
Fernandez going to have to take a faceoff with Brashear bearing down against Lashoff.
You know, you're on the bench. You're on the bench, Jack, and you're saying, come on, guys, we're getting our opportunities. We see what works against this team. It's clearly evident if we play a certain way, we will get our opportunities. And once we're able to break the ice and get a goal, perhaps now we can feed off that.
Brashear can't wheel the shot through, but he's still battling for the puck. Boyd Gordon far side. Dave Steckel goes into Weidman's corner. Sloan at the point, having trouble with the puck. Kovacsuk gets it to center. Brashear rescues it. Cody. Tyler Sloan. Off of Kessel. Kessel's onside. Bergeron off the wall. It hits Sloan's legs. Bergeron stays with it. Brashear tries to staple in corner. Bergeron shovels it over to Kessel. Lucic to Weidman at the point. The wrist shot knocked down in front. Lash off. Quickly back into the corner for Bergeron. Pokes it past Cody. Brashear hard against Kessel. Kessel goes a tumbling. Sloan off the end boards to Cody. Back to Sloan. Kessel is the chaser. Cody on the half wall defensive zone. Lucic gloves the puck down. Steckel over to help out. Savard goes into the corner. Slips it to Lucic. The shot blocked down. When Tyler Sloan made the block there for Washington as we go into the final minute of the second period. Chara beats Ovechkin to the puck and it's icing.
Hey, Cats fans, would you like to own an actual game you stick?
Loon Mountain and WBCN have teamed up to bring you the Skate and Ski program this winter. For any December home game, purchase 4 Skate and Ski Bruins tickets for just $104 and receive 1 lift ticket to Loon Mountain. For tickets, visit bostonbruins.com.
Savard wins the faceoff from Boyd Gordon. Lucic back to Chara. He wrists it through the corner. Sloan against Kessel far side. Ovechkin wants to reverse it and rams it all the way back out to center. Chara goes right back into the zone. Kessel attacking, goes by Sloan. Kessel in front to Lucic. He scores! The Bruins have scored with 35 seconds to go in the second period. It's a new hockey game.
This is a heads-up play by Chara. Once Ovechkin goes hard around against the grain to get the puck out of his own zone, Chara does exactly the same, and it's a beautiful read by Kessel. Those great hands to collect that puck off the wall, and he sells the shot. Johnson comes out to challenge. The 2-on-1 opportunity, well executed by the two kids, Kessel and Lucic. 8th of the year for Milan Lucic. That matches the 8 he had last year, but what a play by Kessel. Handling the puck, stepping off the wall. That subtle look as if I'm going to shoot this puck. It freezes Johnson and makes a perfect pass. And Lucic, all he has to do is redirect.
10 goals, 7 assists, 17 points in 13 consecutive games for Phil Kessel. The second longest scoring streak in the NHL this season. And Kessel is arriving as a league-wide star. And look at the energy that Blake Wheeler takes out of this.
Doesn't that tie the record, tie the longest streak at 13 with Malkin?
Well, Malkin had 16, but I'll look it up between periods.
All right, I thought it was 13.
Carl Alsner will let the clock run out. The Bruins are going to get an emotional pump going into the room here. Brick, what does it mean to score this late in the period of a game in which you've been battling and battling?
Well, it goes to the question you asked me. Are the players getting frustrated? I'm saying no. They know they're going to get their opportunities. Put some pressure on this defense. Create the turnovers by getting the pucks in deep. Challenge their defense. You know you'll get opportunities. Johnson's been good, but once we have a chance and we score, now it opens up.
38 years ago tonight, Johnny Bucyk, Hall of Famer, number retired for the Bruins, number 9 in black and gold, had 2 goals and 4 assists, slashing his way through the Buffalo Sabres in his 1,000th NHL game. The Bruins that night had 72 shots on goal, and there is the Chief. who has filled, I don't know, about a half a dozen different roles with the Bruins, and he has become Mr. Bruin.
I'm his idol, you know.
Yeah, he told me that.
All right, Caps fans, it's a third period.
And by the way, Brick, you were right. 13 games by Phil Kessel equals the longest scoring streak in the league, and I know you wouldn't remind me of that, like, say, on the instigators. Make me feel bad. Would you?
I'll tell you something about that feeling. It goes away.
All right, a little shout out for Chase Wheeler, son of our director, Rose. He's celebrating his 21st birthday today, so happy birthday, Chase. 2-1. Bruins fans hope the score doesn't stay 2-1 for long. Jara feeds Kobesu at the red line pass to Ovechkin. Interesting to note that Mark Savard has as many shots as Alex Ovechkin and Alexander Semin combined. Chara sweeps Semin's stick right out of his hands. Backstrom against Bergeron. Hunwick to Chara. The captain finds a little bit of space, goes indirect to Axelsson out of the zone. He's got Bergeron in the middle. Axelsson pulls up, has to make the move at the line as Morrison gave him a little bit of a resistance, and it's offside.
And Axelsson giving the linesman a little bit of a look, saying, hey, he might have beat me into the zone, but the puck was already there. You're not going to win those arguments. Linesman right on the blue line making the call, but Axelsson felt he made the right play by carrying that puck way out in front of him.
Savard and Michael Nylander on the faceoff. Nylander tries to go right through it and does with the body, winning the faceoff. Weidman behind Fernandez. Puck bounces. Savard taps to Lucic. Hard pass. Kessel trying to play it indirect, but it bounces over his stick to Alsner. And then Yurchina chucks it into the Washington bench. And it's deflected off of Kessel's stick, so the faceoff will be outside the line.
Yeah, Bruins looking for a penalty call on Yurchina inside his own zone, scaling that puck up out of play, but the referee right on it, immediately saying deflection.
Weidman going over and asking for a clarification. On-ice officials seem very sure of that call. Now Nylander gets thrown out of the draw. Kozlov goes in, hulking over the dot against Savard, and Savard wins it back to Lajoie. Lajoie drives it in behind Johnson, forcing the D to do some work. Alsner goes off the end board. Lucic hops right on it to Kessel, trying to ram it in the short side as Johnson moved off the post. Now here comes Kozlov, the big guy, through the seam to Giroux. He's in alone on Fernandez. Saved by Fernandez. A penalty coming against the Bruins. It'll be a penalty shot. Was he deprived of the opportunity to score?
Absolutely not. Fernandez had to make a big-time save with a blocker right side of his body. Yeah, this one's hard to believe. Nice pass through center ice. Giroux with separation. Weidman and Lashoff trying to get back. We saw a penalty call to Ovechkin on the Axelsson breakaway. We didn't see a penalty shot call. Yeah, we're going to see a penalty shot call on this opportunity for Giroux.
1:22 into the third period, turning point in this game. It'll be 3-1 or still a 1-1 game. Giroux against Fernandez, the wide move. He misses wide. Fernandez was doing his best not to commit. Giroux tried to leave the puck behind and snap it in on the near post.
Well, it almost seems as if this is some kind of justice because you don't agree with the penalty shot call. A nice play by Fernandez, confident in goal, holding his ground, protecting for the big sweep to the back end, but again, staying true, staying square. It keeps that right blocker, right pad, in good position to deny Giroux.
Hey, all things considered, I think the Bruins would rather have the penalty shot than face a 2-minute Washington power play with fresh ice.
Yeah, you can say that now.
Holdy, the big swiveling move, goes all the way forward to the goal line. Now Pody in the right wing corner, fires it across the crease, but Fernandez tracks it well, and there is no loose puck with Osola locked in the paint.
And the point to really bring out is you can't allow those opportunities through center ice. Plain and simple. Can't let players get in behind you. Can't allow two-on-ones when you're trailing by a goal in the third period on the road to a team that's dominant at home.
Brooks Like and David Krejci on the faceoff to the right of Fernandez. Krejci wins it straight back. Stewart tries to get away from Osula. Off the end boards from 90 through the corner. Ryder tips it forward to Krejci. Krejci goes around the glass to Wheeler. It's over his stick. Stewart chops it in front. Krejci shot saved. Johnson, he sprawls out and covers. But with that sequence, starting with Krejci's faceoff win, the Bruins move the puck 200 feet forward.
Let's take a look at the two opportunities tonight in breakaways. Here's Axelsson, clearly in alone. There's the little hook that got Ovechkin a penalty. This looks awfully similar to me in the opposite direction. Lashoff reaches in, a little bit of a hook. Both players get real good scoring chances out of it. One's a penalty shot, one's not.
Weidman stick handles around Brashear. Lashoff shot hits the corner boards. Weidman retrieves with Brashear on him. Matt Lashoff goes up the wall. Wheeler tips it into the zone. Morrison can't get it past Wheeler cleanly. Steckel picks it up. Big body turns down. Lashoff side, the wrist shot. Fernandez juggles it, makes the save, and then cleans out in front of his own doorstep. Weidman actually took the brunt of Fernandez's little shove.
Yeah, I thought it was Donald Brashear that upended Dennis Weidman. I think Weidman was looking for a potential penalty. But the Bruins don't hold their blue line in this case, and it's definitely Brashear that comes in and knocks down Weidman. No penalty gonna result from that contact. But I thought Matt Lashoff, Jack, had an opportunity to stand up. Weidman kind of had the puck carrier angled right by the Bruins bench. But the Bruins back in a little too deep for really a one-man rush.
Ovechkin out high, can't get it through to Semin cleanly, who gets a little bit back on his skates and stumbles. Yell busts through the seam against Morrison, but good defensive support coming across from Collins. Thornton chops it right on, and Johnson makes the save and holds the short post. But the very thing that Sean Thornton was talking to us about in the Ford Dealers intermission report, bringing that energy and producing chances.
Yeah, it was a nice play by Yell, and even though he can't step inside his check, on the backhand move, he stays with it, follows the puck, gets a little contact with Collins, and it allows Nokalainen and Thornton to get close support.
Chara loops it in, trouble for Johnson, juggling it. Thornton dives into the crease to keep it alive, and it bounces back. Backstrom lofts it to center, but it's over Semin's reach. Hunwick forward for Yell. Chara with a big hit, sending Ovechkin reeling backward. Sean Collins slips a short pass for Backstrom through Thornton. Nokalainen knocks him down at the Boston line. Thornton over the red line, wraps it in, and the puck deflects out of play. An adventure for Brent Johnson on a lob.
Well, the phrase is get pucks to the net. You never know what's going to happen. Has a little trouble with the glove hand handling it. Thornton with a great second effort to get to that puck. He also talked, John Thornton did in the intermission, about winning more one-on-one battles, and that's something we pointed out, Jack, that when they do get the puck in deep, they needed to win more one-on-one battles, and they have. It started in the later stages or the second half of that second period. The Bruins trying to build off that here in the third.
Bergeron, a short pass to Kovacsuk. Chris crosses it with Axelsson. There's a broken stick. It's Kovacsuk's. So the Bruins have to hustle back. Kovacsuk picks up the lumber as he glides past the bench. Cody low for Giroux. Into the corner to Kozlov. Kozlov holds his ground on Stewart's bump. Nylander tries to cycle it away from Kovacsuk. Spins to the forehand. Goes back to the backhand. Tyler Sloan missed stick handles. Bergeron can't pump it out of the zone. Second chance, he nudges it to center. Stewart goes cross ice, tap pass to Kovacsuk. Pulls it up against Sloan, holds the wrist shot. Goes well wide. Sloan pass Lucic to center. Kozlov feeding it forward. Light shot, well wide. A stick check by the Bruins. Lucic getting back on Stewart's side of the ice. Lucic nudges it up the wall. Osler throwing it into the pile. Bradley turns down into the corner against Weidman. Bradley off the half wall. Good stick position by Lucic. Savard carries it into the zone. Lucic lunging forward for the puck. Here comes Bradley trying to feed it forward to Brooks. Light on the off wing against Lashoff. Lashoff pokes it wide to the board. Light controls. Lashoff gets it loose again. Savard. Kessel goes well wide to open up space. Savard going down the middle. Kessel to the middle. Kessel shovels it in with a backhand. Didn't get much on it. And Johnson sprays it to the wall. Savard working for Kessel, but he can't get it through Yurchina's stick check. Lucic jamming for the puck. Yurchina comes cross ice to Oscar Osla, and he wrists it into the corner, and the Caps get a change.
Well, Savard had a chance. He thought he could zip a quick pass to Kessel. It was well defended by the Caps with stick position. Otherwise, Kessel's right in the high slot.
Chara off of Wheeler's skates. It's offside. Brashear. No, a hooking call coming.
Yeah, a penalty to the Caps. Bruins with an opportunity to make a play through center ice. But Collins is going to go to the box. And what an opportunity for Boston. They've had some puck possession in the offensive zone. They've had some opportunities. Kopitar, who had a stick break on him right when he's going to let a shot fly. Middle of the screen, Collins just trying to stand up on Wheeler, but guilty of the hooking call. And the Bruins trying to build off some of that pressure they've established here in the third period with their man advantage.
0 for 2 on the power play. The Bruins 2 for 6 Monday against Tampa Bay, including a 5-on-3 goal. 6 power play goals for the Bruins in their last 5 games. Coming into this game, Washington is 3 for 3 on the kill in Sunday's loss to Carolina, but allowed 4 power play goals in his previous 4 games. It's Ryder to Axelson, the drive. Big juicy rebound off Johnson's save. And he seems to come up a little bit shaken, rolling that glove side shoulder.
That was a bullet by Axelson. And Tom Pody tried to stand up, and his defensive blue line was moving forward. Ryder stepped right around him.
Ryder with possession, shoots just wide. Rebound, Johnson lunges and sticks it away from Ryder. Axelson back to Bergeron with a lot of space. Over to Chara, top of the circle. Can't settle the puck quickly. Bergeron's drive is a high rocket off the glass. Savard first on it, shovels it back to Chara. Rolling puck back to Savard. Cuts to the middle. Now it's Axelson back to Chara. Savard on the far side, rotating top of the circle. Chara's one time and save Johnson. Rebound back to the dot. And Bradley sends it all the way down to Fernandez.
Johnson, the best penalty killer right now for the Washington Caps. Bruins getting a number of good looks.
About 3/4 of a minute to go in Sean Collins' hooking penalty. And Morrison backhands it all the way back down to Fernandez. Stuckel having a look. Hunwick leaves it for Weidman. He's got Krejci on the right and gives it to him. Krejci across the Hunwick, off the skates. Alsner can't chop it out of the zone of the backhand. Krejci goes in and staples Alsner in the corner. Nudges it over to Kessel. Kessel dances back in the goal for Lucic. It comes all the way through to Hunwick. Ah, Krejci dangerous, top of the circle. Krejci closes looking for Lucic. He tips it toward goal. I think it went off his skates. And Johnson clamps down with 14 seconds to go on the penalty kill for Washington.
Well, both units getting real good opportunities, real good looks, creating plays with the man advantage. Axelson had a great chance when Ryder just steps right around Tom Pody, feeds it over to Axelson. Axelson sees that Johnson's going immediately into that butterfly style, and he puts the shot up high.
Weidman's drive off Krejci's faceoff win, and Johnson comes well out to make the glove stop. 3 more seconds tick off the power play, and the Bruins will take another faceoff in the attacking zone. Lucic wondering what the heck's going on as he was getting knocked down in traffic. Good hard hockey being played out here in the third.
Yeah, Lucic is a little frustrated. He thought there was penalty opportunities to be called on his last shift out there when he got all tied up right around the faceoff dot.
I got a feeling that 30 years from now, Lucic and Thomas Holmstrom are going to be able to have a pretty good conversation. Penalty expires. Caps are at full strength. Krejci goes in and bangs Ovechkin. Ovechkin bursts forward on Hunwick's side, throws it right into Hunwick's legs. Lucic, the pass deflected off Backstrom. The crowd in D.C. trying to rally the calf. Backstrom turns it into a 3-on-2. Feeds it through. Backstrom's backhand and save. Backstrom goes off the side of the goal with Fernandez down and a side open. Kessel chops it through the neutral zone. It won't be icing.
How elusive is Backstrom? He just kept getting separation as he moved laterally inside the Bruins' defensive zone. He gets to the middle. And a nifty little feed to Semin through traffic.
It was said to be a worldwide search for a center for Alexander Ovechkin, and the Caps were delighted when Backstrom was still on the board at number four overall in 2006. Here comes Ovechkin. Stewart deprives him of the shot. Thornton follows Ovechkin to the corner. Semin on the half wall. Takes a funny bounce off glass. Chara spins it back to the wall. Nokalainen chops the puck through center. Thornton chasing hard against Morrison. Now Nokalainen comes in. Yell deflects the outlet pass. Collins up the wall. Giroux deflects it in on Fernandez. About 11 minutes to go. Through the neutral zone, no icing all the way in on Johnson anyway. Kovacsuk takes it out of the air. Can't black it back on goal. Tyler Sloan got in the way. Kozlov far side feeds it quickly to Nylander. He crisscrosses with Giroux. Nylander over the line. Giroux trying to go low. Lashoff pokes it away and sends the puck to the boards. Lashoff winning that one-on-one battle. Then he takes the body to move the puck to 90. Over to Kovacsuk. Kovacsuk comes cross ice. Wheeler at the red line. Can't get it through Cody. Nylander at the Boston line. Again, Lashoff stands up. Wheeler back to help out. Bergeron also there. Nylander chops it up in the air. Bouncing puck. Nylander finds control. Pirouettes to the corner. Wheeler trying to shut down his space. Lashoff on the kick plate. Battling hard. Kozlov keeps it alive. Alder chips it off 90. Kozlov on the far side. Cycles it. Pass Osoleta, Nylander. 90 shoves in. Kozlov at the dot. The shot saved by Fernandez. Lashoff pokes it back into the corner. Good cycling on this shift by the Caps. They bring some pressure against Manny Fernandez.
The Bruins did a decent job of keeping everything to the perimeter except for the Kozlov chance. And even that was from a tough angle.
But considering how the game has gone, I would imagine that Bruce Boudreau's charges are happy to see the puck in the Boston end of the ice for a couple of seconds.
Yeah, that was a shift that they needed, the Washington Capitals, something up in the offensive zone because they were really spending far too much time in their own end, and they've been shorthanded.
Out of the corner, Alzer from the point for Light, back of the goal. Bradley circling in front. Light pulls it out to the half wall. Alzer's shot well wide. Hunwick wins the race to the puck. Light tips it toward the middle. Lucic feeds it indirect for Kessel. He has to wait and decides to regroup. Now he goes long diagonal, firing it past Savard's reach. And Yurchina touches the puck first. Kessel's clear in from behind the red line, so it's icing. Friday night at 7. Join Catherine Tappan and Gord Kluzak from our SNHD Television Center. They bring you up to speed before the Bruins take on the Atlanta Thrashers in the first half of a two nights home and home series. They bring you all the latest NHL news. WB Mason, Bruins face off live Friday night at 7 on Nesson. Dave Steckel battles Savard for the faceoff. Cody jumps up. Lashoff indirect for Lucic with Kessel coming late. Lucic can't move inside. Boy, Jordan throws the hip and gets mostly glass. Cody trickles it forward to Brashear. Savard can't pick his pocket cleanly. Kessel off the far side. Wheeler with a big reach, but then the puck dies for Kessel. For Steckel. Steckel over the line. Gordon's driving a glove. Save Fernandez with a flourish. He'll take the faceoff with 8:53 to go in the game. The Caps hanging on to a 2-1 lead in D.C. 8:53 to go. A ton of time here. How that Lucic goal with 35 seconds to go in the second period changed things. Charles with the heads-up play, sending it back around. And talk about heads-up, here comes David Krejci. He throws it into Collins' corner, takes the bump. Krejci wins the puck in the corner. Gets it back to 90. 90's wrist shot off Gordon's stick. Comes off the dasher and bounces down to Boyd Gordon. Falling down, he flips it toward the Washington bench, and it got in there and came out. And now the nastiness begins to bubble to the surface with Donald Brashear grinning in the middle of the pile.
Well, with the faceoff to start this action back in the Bruins zone, Bo Julian has Stefan Yell on the ice taking the draw with David Krejci lining up on the inside hash mark, and it led to a nice breakout for Boston and allowed the Bruins to get the puck into the offensive end, complete their line change, get Wheeler and Reiner back out there along with Krejci. Krejci with a heads-up play, chip it in behind the defense, behind Collins, go get it, use your point, man. Unfortunately, tonight he had a shot block.
Brashear is ranked in the top 20 in terms of number of fighting majors. He has 12 so far this season. The Bruins leader is Sean Thornton, who has gone to battle six times. Milan Lucic has fought three times. incidentally, Brian Poffier has not been able to play all year and has had to shut down his training for a while for the Caps. He is now attempting to retrain his eyesight after a concussion suffered on a Milan Lucic body check in a Caps Bruins game last year. Krejci trying to step around Ovechkin, who's among the league leaders in hits. Cross-ice pass. Ovechkin takes the 7th pass on the off-wing. Hard wrist shot, and Fernandez is sharp. Ovechkin takes a shoulder from Ryder right in the chin, and his pass ricochets back.
After Ovechkin initiated contact with Chart, get to that puck.
Ovechkin pulls up, can't get the pass through the seam as Nokalainen makes the check. Thornton churning up the wing against Pody. Shoves Pody off stride, centering pass, nobody home. Yell in a battle against Semin. The big one-handed reach by Semin gets it to center. Yell nudges it over to Nokalainen to Thornton. The drive save, juicy rebound, far side. Nylander picks it up on the carom. He's got Ovechkin on the near side. On Hunwick's side of the ice, he dumps it in, and the Caps peel off for a line change. Alexander Giroux gathers the puck in, throws it right behind Fernandez. Pressure from Kozlov. Pass out of the zone, does not connect. This is going to be icing against the Bruins, and the drop will come back to the Boston end with about 7 minutes to go. Boston Bruins hockey is brought to you by the 2008 Hess Toy Truck and Front Loader. The Hess Truck and Front Loader with bright lights, big sounds, and a real hydraulic lift. Come in for yours today. Off the icing, they lock the gate at the Bruins bench. So Yell will take the face off against Nylander, and Yell wins it back to Hunwick. Weidman, Thornton tips it across the blue line. Kozlov overskates the puck for a moment, turns back and wires it in behind Fernandez. Weidman slips it into the middle to Bergeron. Out of the zone to Thornton, across the red line. Cross corner dump for Axelsson. The puck just dies. As if it had backspin on it. Axelsson ties up Sean Collins. Bergeron tries to win the one-on-one battle down in the corner. The puck goes loose. Kovacu for Bergeron. Morrison shoves him out of the way. Lashoff goes down hard in the corner. The big drive from Axelsson knocked down in front. Kovacu can't shovel it through the crowd. Bergeron to Kovacu with the dot. Kovacu gets knocked down on the check. Nylander following him all the way back to the corner. Kozlov looking for the outlet. Saucers it right onto Giroux's tape, but he can't control. The Bruins get a line change, and they'll change out the D as well. Brooks like indirect pass for Osola, but it's offside. 6:01 to go in the game. No goals yet in the third period. One for the Caps in the first, and one in the second, and the Bruins answered with Lucic in the final minute of the second period. Nicklas Backstrom's tip of the power play drive from Ovechkin leads the TD Bank North game report. That was the first goal of the game in the first period. In the second, Alexander Giroux, his first of the year, on the doorstep, trickling it past Fernandez for a 2-0 lead. But with less than a minute to go in the second period, Chara to Kessel to Lucic, who rams it in to make it a one-goal game. And that's the way we stand now with about 6 minutes to go. Lucic with a big hit on Yurchina. Looks like at his own line, goes cross ice. Backstrom can't handle the ankle-high pass. Backstrom comes back, and Lucic is right in his face. Cross ice, it's a giveaway to Kessel. Now Weidman switches forward. Wrists it through both corners. Lucic lets it glide. Savard off a skate, and it trickles back into the Boston zone. Washington seems very good at getting in passing lanes and at least getting a piece of passes tonight, Frick.
Well, they have, and I think they've been fortunate in a number of cases because there's been some room to operate.
Savard for Kessel, can't get the shot through Semin's back check. Savard to Weidman, the drive is wide, glove side, a spin around attempt from Kessel, and Yurchina cracks him hard. Ovechkin trying to gather it in on Weidman's side of the ice, the puck too far forward. Chara on the far side. Ovechkin finishes his hit. Semin trickles it behind Fernandez, and Savard and Semin have an exchange. As Savard goes off, David Krejci takes the feed forward from Weidman. Krejci goes low, tries to pick the top short side. Stewart wraps it back around through the corner. Wheeler going to work against Sloan. Sloan lifts it out of the zone. Krejci, Lashoff. Lashoff hard through the middle. Krejci tips it in behind Johnson. Sloan leaves it on the end boards. Krejci pops it up against Pody. Pody gloves it over to Sloan. Wheeler looking for a centering pass. Elects to go back to the goal to Ryder. Ryder indirect looking for Stewart. He had to protect the line against Matt Bradley. Bradley holds and spoons it into the Boston bench off of Michael Ryder's glove. The faceoff on the center dot with 4:16 to go in the game. Shots are 32-23 Boston, but the Caps cling to a one-goal lead. They've pumped up the crowd in Washington, but the Bruins hope to silence them in the final 4:16. After the final horn tonight, the action continues from our SNHD Television Center. Bruins Overtime Live presented by AceTicket.com. Catherine Tappan and Mike Milbury have the game's analysis for you. Reaction from the Bruins dressing room. It's tonight, right after the game. And then don't forget Sports Desk with Cole Wright follows immediately. Well, the points are on the line right here. The Bruins have done everything but tie it. Chara in a race for the puck. Osner gets it forward to Steckel, the shot. Handcuffs Fernandez. Unwick was able to turn it to the corner. Chara comes up the wall for Wheeler. Indirect looking for Krejci, but it glides all the way to Urchina. Across to Carl Alders. Up the wall for Nylander. Fernandez stops it, and Washington will take a short shift here as we go inside 4 minutes to play. Unwick, the long outlet just past Ryder's reach. And this is going to be icing as the Bruins try to stretch it a little bit. And they've missed a couple times and been called for icing.
Yeah, I was curious if they were going to stay with the icing call because Alsner, Jack, turned towards the inside and not turned to the outside where the puck was. In many cases, they'll wave that icing call off when a defenseman does that.
Ovechkin in the shooter's spot, top of the circle. As Nicholas Backstrom tries to win it back. Wheeler alert to that, goes into the circle. Fernandez hooks it to Hunwick. Now Chara. Past Ovechkin. Ryder going cross ice. Wheeler takes it on the backhand against Pody to the middle. Krejci through the slot. The puck comes to the near side. Backstrom lifts it. Chara gloves it down at the line, knowing Ovechkin's going to hit him. Pody nudges it to the Boston line. Flash off, backs in, his pass deflects off a stick. Patrice Bergeron into the left wing corner. Yell going after it. Pody tries to shut him down. Backstrom shovels it over. Semin cross ice. Chara intercepts the pass and sends it for Ovechkin. Kovacu back for Bergeron. Floats it in on Johnson, and he has to take the faceoff in his end under 3 minutes to go.
Well, I think you got to like what Washington's doing if you're a Boston Bruins fan. They're really not making plays through the neutral zone. They're not getting pucks in deep with any kind of regularity. And Boston's able to counterattack consistently, get pucks in the offensive zone. You never know what can happen. They're just a shot away from tying this thing. The Capitals need to look to make more plays coming out of their own end if they want to protect the 2-1 lead.
Kessel in the shooter's spot here, top of the circle. And Savard tries to win it against Brooks Light. Light takes the draw. Back to Alsner, backhands it around. Lashoff takes the Bradley hit to keep the puck in the zone, but only for the moment. Gordon chopping down into the corner. Light turns it to the circle. Just wants to keep it in the attacking zone. Getting toward the 2.5 minute mark to go. Carl Alsner wraps it down into the corner. Gordon to Light. Lashoff shuts down Light's progress. Kessel tips it forward to Lucci. Lucci has Weidman filling in the middle. Weidman to Savard over the line, goes for the drive, tipped. Weidman on the end boards. Lucci comes off the wall. Back to Savard. Savard's wrist shot, easy save for Johnson, and he spills it out, wanting to keep the clock moving. But the Bruins will get a faceoff in the attacking zone with 2:16 left.
You know, the Bruins couldn't get any traffic in front of Johnson on the shot from long distance by Savard. Bruins with an opportunity off this rush because Weidman jumps into the play. Weidman kicks it wide to Savard, goes to the net, but it was a good shot block by the Caps.
Bergeron, Kovacu, and Wheeler the line for Claude Julien's Bruins. Dave Steckel trying to win the draw back and does on the second effort. Pody around the glass. Chara pinches it against the board. Bergeron wheels and fires hard to the end boards. Pody starts it out left side. Can't connect, coming out of the zone. Chara sends it right back in, trying to trouble the Washington D. Tom Pody against Blake Wheeler. Chara jumps down to the half wall, deflects it up into the circle. Steckel after it. Strong on the puck to Kozloff. And he whacks it in towards Fernandez with 1:40 to go in the game. Chara center circle. Wheeler can't control. Alsner and Nylander. Chara past Ovechkin. Chara taps it past Kessel's reach. Backstrom forward to Semin. He's got Ovechkin on the near side. Semin tries to sprint past Hunwick. He'll take it to the corner to try to bleed the clock. We go into the final 1.25 minutes. Hunwick to Chara. To Savard. We'll keep an eye on Fernandez if he makes a move to the bench. Kessel's the front man. Savard reads it and goes into the zone. Fernandez goes out. Possible the extra skater in the goalie pole. Ovechkin has an empty goal behind Lashoff. Alex Ovechkin ends it.
Well, Savard made the right decision on that long-distance wraparound because he had Kessel way up the ice. And then Lucic trying to keep this play alive along the board. The Bruins don't win that battle. And Ovechkin's going to take that nice feed from Semin right out in the neutral zone. Lashoff tried to step in and steal the puck. Couldn't get there in time. And now Ovechkin with an empty netter. He's not going to miss. 3-1 Caps.
Bruins call timeout with 51.9 showing on the stadium clock at center. Ovechkin with a goal and an assist tonight to boost his team leading totals to 15 goals and 22 assists.
Assist by number 28, Alexander.
For the 100th time in Alex Ovechkin's rather brief career, he has posted a multi-point game.
Well, he came into tonight's action trailing the NHL scoring leader, Evgeny Malkin, by 10 points, 45-35, as we get a look at the empty netter. Crosby in second place with 41 points entering today's games. So Ovechkin really climbing that scoring ladder, streaking right now for the Caps.
Light into Weidman's corner. Over to Chara, gets caught up in the referee's skates. And Boyd's shot. Gordon throwing it on Fernandez, and he makes the stop. Half a minute to go in this one. The Bruins need a remarkable finish. Milan Lucina into the pile. Carl Alsner bumps it low. Boyd Gordon gives it up on the check. Bergeron out of the zone. It rolls down the slot. Alsner turns it away with about 15 seconds to go. And so the Bruins will take a multi-goal defeat. I believe for just the second time this season. And the crowd in Washington loves it. Where the Caps improved to 11-1 at home and end Boston's five-game winning streak. 3-1 to 1. In an 82-game season, you're going to have some games where you have excellent confrontations between teams that lead their divisions, and Washington got the better of it on the scoreboard tonight.
It was a competitive game, no doubt. I thought Brett Johnson was probably the first star in this hockey game, the goaltender for the Washington Capitals. The Bruins had opportunities, timely opportunities that they were unable to finish. But the good thing about this game, Jack, is the sport of hockey, I mean, at times it's humbling. And when coaches try to keep teams grounded when they're on tremendous rolls, sometimes a well-timed loss can work to your advantage. And we'll have to see if that does, because the Bruins have back-to-back with Atlanta coming up.